Hi guys, it's Emily from Novel Novels and welcome to today's video. This is the DNF tag. Now, I was tagged in it by the lovely Melissa from Fully Booked, and I've actually got the creator here today. I actually found the creator's video and I'll actually link their original video. It was from Nell and Scott at Gunpowder Fiction and Plot. I'm new to their channel. I'm doing a part of Crime and Punishment read along with Scott. He's actually in the group, and I've checked out their channel because they've been recommended by so many of my friends. So I thought I'd do this tag today. Now, I'm not great at DNFing, but we'll go into that as the prompts go on. So I've not really written the answers down in my notes because I'm gonna try and just be open and honest and not plan too much. Not to mention I've just got gone jogging, so I'm a bit tired. Okay, so let's get down to the first prompt. Do you DNF? Yes, but not enough. There is so many times I've got too far into a book to think I've wasted. I feel like I've wasted the time. If I don't continue the book or finish the book, then I feel like I've wasted the time I've spent reading those pages that I've read. So say if I've got like 25 pages into a book or 50 pages in, I will easily DNF. But if I go a bit further in, like up to 100, then I find it really hard to put the book down because it will be like I've wasted time, and I hate wasting time that I'm reading. I really see any time in my life, I'm just not a time waster at all, can't stand it. And also if I'm buddy reading a book, then I really will not DNF it. And that will link down to one of the answers that are coming up soon. Next one is number two. If you DNF a book, does it count towards your books for reading for the month? Now, now that I've got my planner, I'm a lot better at it. I will put a DNF in the planner so that way I know that I've tried it, but not that I've been successful. But it depends on if it's gone on Goodreads. So for my figures I use from my journal, no, it doesn't count. No way, there's no point because it's not been completed. But if I've put a book on Goodreads and then I DNF it, I've yet to work out how to go from unread or going from reading to DNF. I don't know how to do that. So I put it down as read, but then I don't put a star rating and I put a comment of DNF so that way I know in myself it doesn't count, but unfortunately the Goodreads counts it. So it's stuffing up my Goodreads amount for the month. I hate that. So I'm trying to get better at not putting it on Goodreads unless I know that I'm gonna push past that 200 limit. That's a bit of a rambling answer. Dreadfully sorry about that. Is there a difference between a DNF and putting it down for a bit? Yes. If I've picked it up and I've DNF'd it and I know there is no chance I will ever want to go read it away, I will put it away and I'll give it away. But if, say, I've DNF'd a book because I've just, like, I'm not in the right space for it. I've got a fantasy book that's still to one side that my friend Hazel's lent me that I had to DNF because it's not really the right time, but I'm not going to give it back to her because I do want to try it when I'm feeling a bit brighter. So sometimes you're not really in the mood for a book and it's not right, so you will DNF it, but I will attempt to go back to it. So yeah, kind of, does that make sense? And then, which popular book did you DNF? I DNF'd Captain Corelli's Mandoline. It was my TBR jar pick for a month. And I picked it up, and within about 20 seconds of it, virtually less than 20 pages, I was like, I don't like this. I don't know what it is. I couldn't, for the life of you, I couldn't tell you why, but just the writing style was just totally not for me. And I was like, no, I bought it because it was one that had been talked about so many times. Yeah, I actually really didn't like it. So sorry, guys, I DNF'd that one. What book do you wish you'd DNF'd? Vox. Read it this month with Chloe from Chloe Reads Things. I'm just double checking her name. Chloe Reads Books, there you go. I've actually written her channel name down. There you go, Chloe, get in there. Yeah, we already read this book this month in September and I hated it. I hated it from start to blooming finish. That's another one that counts as a popular book because a lot of people have loved it. I couldn't stand it. It is one that I am so angry about, and it's not very often that I get angry about a book, but it was just not for me. There was so much in there that just did my nut, and I just wish I would have DNF'd it. But because I was buddy reading it, even though me and Chloe thought we both had to push past it, but it was one we both wanted to just get rid of, can't stand it. I'm now thinking of even rating to put in the star rating down to one, That is how bad it was in my eyes. Next one is, do you attempt to reread a DNF and has it been successful for you? So I've actually, for the first time, for the first prompt, I've actually got some books here. Yes, I do attempt to DNF. This one was a very big one that I'm very, very, very glad I read. I DNF'd this one because I started reading it two, three years ago. It was one my sister Charlie lent me originally, and I DNF'd it because it was not one for me, Heartless. Then I think this year or last year, I reread it. Julie gave me a copy of it, and I actually really loved it. It was one of my, that ended up being one of my favourite books. It's my first Marissa Vyer book, and I loved it. And I am so badly gonna, this is actually one of the few books that I've actually read and ended up keeping, because it went from a DNF to a 5-star. I need to read more of her books. Guys, can you please let me know some hints from Marissa Vyer books, apart from the Luna Chronicles, which you guys know I love. And another book, I DNF'd this because I read it on audiobook, my library audiobook, and it didn't like it. But I've since heard that it's brilliant, and I now Leanne Moriarty is one of my favourite authors. So it's on my shelves, and I'm actually gonna reattempt it. So sometimes, most of the time it's successful when I read it, if I'm gonna reread it. I don't reread very often my DNF because I normally know, but it depends on what level of DNF, how badly I hated the book, if whether I keep it and whether I DNF it. What do you do with the books you DNF? Charity shop, or if I think a friend will like it, I will give it to a friend if I know it's their genre, but most of the time it's charity shops. Sometimes I wish I could put them in the bin, but I could never hurt a book. Books are treasures, you can never hurt them. So they go to charity shops because other people might love them. Just because they're not for me doesn't mean they're not for you. And guys, if I ever, in my like unhauls or in my wrap-ups, if there's ever a book you see that I say I'm giving rid of, let me know. I'll keep it for you. I'm trying to be nice. Right, next one. Do you choose more or less risky books because of your stance on DNF? To be honest, I choose less risky books because I hate to DNF it. But it depends on, if a book looks risky, if a book looks like it's scary for me, I will save it for something like a read song when it's going to have a purpose, because then that will make it less likely that I will DNF it. So if it's for a read along or if it's for a readathon, I will still read a risky book. But if it's just in general, no, I'm a bit more scared. I'm a bit scared of buying books, in all honesty, if they look too risky, because to me, I don't want to waste the book and waste money. So I'm a bit of a wimp. I do tend to be a bit sort of scaredy cat. I don't like DNFing. I really hate it. And I hate picking up a book and then putting it down. But I hate reading a book and wasting my time on it. So drives me insane. So yeah, I'm a bit of a wimp. But I am trying. I am trying to be more risky. I'm trying to push those boundaries. Go for it. Try risky books. And this is finally, I've got a shorter video. Woohoo, you guys. Not a long one for me. This is pretty good. Thanks, Nell and Scott. Thanks, Melissa. Liking this. Right, so now, tag 5 booktube buddies or however many people you want. So, I decided that today I would go through my subscriber list, look at some names, think about people who, check out people who haven't done it. And if you guys have done it in the between me making this video and doing it, then obviously don't worry about it. But that's how I picked names early, sort of up on the alphabetical list. So guys, if you want to do it, do it. If you don't, don't. And if there's any of you out there that I don't tag, please feel free to do it anyway and let me know you've done it. Link me. So the first person I'm tagging is Angie from Ange with an E. I'd love to see her do this. I think she'd make me laugh her head off. She's such a funny lady. Another new to me channel, and I think she's frigging fantastic. Next one's Becca's from Becca's Bookshelves. God, if you want a video to make you laugh, she doesn't like sort of similar books to me very often, apart from her non-fiction. We have that in common. She likes sort of scarier horror books. But her videos make me laugh and make me smile. She is so energetic, fun, and I love her. So, Becca, I'd love to see you do this. You'll make me crack up laughing. Next one is Charlie from Charles Heathcote. Charlie, again, great guy, makes me smile all the time. Absolutely love him. I think he's one of my best booktube buddies. He doesn't like compliments, but no, just giving you one. And I'd love to see him do this because he would make me laugh the way he is. His northern sense of humour, he just, oh my God, it would make, he would make me smile. Next one is Chloe. This is one of your revenge, but one of my revenge tags. Chloe from Chloe Reads Books. Finally mentioned her channel name because I keep always forgetting her channel name. Even though she is one of my BookTube besties, a brilliant friend, someone I absolutely friggin' adore. If you like my videos like her, she's amazing. She is so brilliant. Just check her out. She's literally one of the best people ever on. And then Amy from PS I Love Books and Things. Another BookTube friend, another darling. She is so sweet. She doesn't do very many channels. She hasn't got, I'll tell you what, Amy, Becca and Angie do not have anywhere near enough subscribers. They are absolutely, all three of them are absolute lovely ladies, and check their channels out, boost them up, go for it, get their numbers up and just support them because they're lovely ladies. Obviously, you know I love Charlie and Chloe. They've been my friends for ages, so. Anyway, guys, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel and not subscribed yet, ring my ding-a-ling, and I'll see you all soon.